And Highmore going after a check, comes up with a puck, and it's an offside as Highmore is bumped by Gajewicz, and two of them will have extra words. Well, Tkachuk and Mikkola were all tangled up the side of the net on the icing call.
But that is
Brodsky, couldn't see it, landed right in front of him, and he finds it in time to cover it up.
Well, full marks to Norris. Not only did, well, he gets hit with the puck, he didn't see it coming, but he blocks the puck from going to the net. Then he gets on his horse and he just flies down the ice. Ekblad thinks he's gonna
gets knocked out of the line by Sanderson. Angle one off for Stützle, and Stützle gets pulled into the boards by Gajewicz. Puck jumped on, he's forcing a cross. Oh, what a save by Korpisalo off of Ekblad. Interference call here as Korpisalo comes up with his second big save of the night.
Well, a tit for a tat here as we get a good solid hit. There's the line change on the shorthanded turnaround. Quick transition. They get it to Tkachuk and he rips this thing and just wide on the far side. And then Bennett with a shot from the high slot. Good save by Korpisalo. Stützle with his head down. Gajewicz pounds through him. And right there, you see Tarasenko come.
Hello. We'll make the stop and cover it up, and they'll get a little shoving here the side of the net afterwards as frustrations start to boil over a little bit here for Ottawa. Well, the Western Conference now will get a little mix-up here inside the blue line at the end of the period.
Well, Bart, this is Tkachuk and Korpisalo have had it been going on here, and I think at the end of that, I think possibly Tkachuk and Korpisalo had a few more words for one another. Now Highmore is going to step in between Korpisalo and Tkachuk, and they're finishing their conversation. Earlier in the period, as you mentioned, Barts, Tkachuk swung back and had a bit of an issue. And now we've got extra guys on the ice here, and I think just got to get your goalie out of there. And cooler heads prevailing there now. Just been a little bit of action around Korpisalo, and you know, you got guys like Bennett and Tkachuk, they love to get under your skin, and certainly they've gotten a bit under the skin of Korpisalo, and right here you see the little whack, and then they have a few words, and
oh, it's fired in by Hamonic, and then McEwen comes across the ice and goes after Matthew Tkachuk. He'll jump on him and now trying to get some shots on after the linesmen were already in there. Bennett now will grab McEwen from behind. He's pulled back down. Zach McEwen made an absolute beeline for Matthew Tkachuk and had only one thing in mind.
Well, you had to expect there was going to be some response. I mean, you come into another team's building and you're beating them, and then you're poking at their goalie. Like, you got to think there's going to be a response of some sort. And he's talking to the bench, he's talking to his brother now, and McEwen
has a 5-minute penalty for elbowing. The play is under review.
We'll get a 5-minute elbowing penalty, as if you see on the clip here, he's going into the corner and he takes a shot at Hamonic. It's not much of an elbow. He comes across with his arm. It's not your prototypical reach back and drive your elbow into someone's head. I think he just runs along the top of Tkachuk's nameplate. At least it looked like that on the first run. And then I think the intention was just to create an altercation with him. And he's saying that he drew blood as well. So it should be at 4, but he's getting to 5. So I don't know, maybe they're going to add more to it. So, and in prime fashion, like, you know, normally when you take a run at somebody like that, they're not going to come and chase your tough guys. They're going to go after your good players. So they're basically saying, you know, for Sanderson and those guys, tell them to keep their head up. We're coming. So this is going to get edgy as we head down these last 14 minutes and 47 seconds, as it looks like the they're going to be handpicked as we head down the stretch.
Well, the brothers even jawing a little bit there, maybe.
Nothing wrong with that. Yeah. Nothing wrong with that. Just be in the old day, you know, they'd come over to your bench and they'd say, we're not coming after your tough guy, we're coming after your best player, right? We're not messing around. So a lot of talk, and Matthew and Brady having some words.
number 17 has been assessed a 5-minute match penalty for checking to the head.
Okay, so not elbowing, checking to the head. That's a, that's... Lewis Tarina knocked it. Right of backhanded in. Bennett blocked it. Pucks come off. And it's Matthew Tkachuk and Jake Sanderson that are going to go here. Well, he said he wanted Sanderson when he was standing by the bench. And Sanderson was like, you want me? You got me. And he's there to answer the bell. And they will head to the box.
Well, things boil over a little in a 3-0 Panthers lead. Ottawa is going to go back to the power play here as they try to get something going in this third period against the Panthers, and a little bit of a spark coming here. Tim Stützle also leading the way here for Ottawa on the third, trying to spark something, Gary.
Well, you know what? They've been trying. The last power play, a couple of good chances. Stützle just got stymied here. Joseph gets out in the neutral zone, and then Montour's making a change. It looked like nothing, and then all of a sudden, he's walking in all alone and a big save, and then right here, the helmet comes off. That'll cost you 2 minutes right there. And then it's two willing participants, and save bumps into him on the way to the net. Kulikov goes after Freddy Tkachuk. The bumps are already up. Everybody piles in, and here we go. Hammond comes off the bench. He'll race down in to grab somebody.
And he ends up grabbing Ekman Larson at the end. He was at the end of a change there, and the Senators were outnumbered, so he came tearing in.
Out of all this, a dump out of the zone, and Brady Tkachuk is coming out of the penalty box, and he snags it on the fly out of the box. And you're right, Bartz, he had his best move was on the Norris's stick that was laying in the middle of the ice in his way. If the stick's not there, he probably has a more direct route to the net, but he has to go around it, as he's still having words with Gadjevic. And Stenlund takes a poke at him, and this thing is going to heat up again, as these guys are not out of energy yet.
Well, this was bound to boil over at some point. And if you're the Ottawa Senators, you're maybe happy to see a little response, but it's a little late in the game here to be doing it. Down 4-0 with 7:22 to go in the third. This is what you want to see earlier.
Well, here comes Brady out of the box, and he snags it on the reverse side, and then he goes around the stick. Tries to go through the five hole, but Bobrovsky holds on to it. I do believe, I'm not sure what the penalty was for after, if it was the slash maybe coming from Kulikov on the original call, and now every player on the ice is getting a penalty. The referee has sent them all, and they've had enough.
Well, Paul Maurice not too happy on the Florida bench here with all of this. And now the brothers are both in the penalty box.
Well, I think he's sending them all home here. I think they're all gone. You just, you know what, for the referee, you gotta sort of grab a handle this, because nobody's listening. No one's separating. It separated and started up.
He throws it towards the goal. Korpisalo to save it. Hold on. Now Joseph goes after Verhegi, back of the net. Bennett comes in. So does Kelly. Barkov in there as well. We'll have another scrum.
Well, they, you know, these kind of scrums are going to continue around the nets for sure. They don't want to give anyone an inch at this point. And Bennett, who's gotten under the skin of a number of Ottawa players, and every time he's on the ice, he's drawn attention.
Ottawa penalty number 21, 10-minute misconduct.
I think this is what you got to start just getting rid of the people that you believe, the players that you believe are going to be your biggest headache. And as soon as you get the chance to unload them, you get rid of them. You just say, okay, two more guys gone. It just makes sense, right?
And Joseph breaking his stick down the hallway. I think tonight we're really starting to see the frustrations of the Senators' season boil over.